Every Saturday night, 9 to 11 Pacific Standard Time on CRN Digital Talk Radio. Now in our 24th year and well over 19,000 guests, The Ron Segi Show Live originates from our Universal Radio Studios. Celebrities from TV, music, movies, literature, politics, and show business, at one time or another, they all come to The Ron Segi Show. So why don't you?
Welcome, everybody, to the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad. Let us entertain you for the next hour.
Let me entertain you. Go ahead, Turkey.
Yeah, thank you, sir. 818-353-1276 is the call-in line. 818-353-1276 is how you get in touch.
853.
You almost did it. 353.
818-353-1276. See, you did it right that time, didn't you?
Thank you. Thank you. All right, let's bring it back, guys. The email address, robertconrad@crntalk.com, to send your emails over. I know a lot of you are phone shy. You're afraid to get behind the horn and give us a call, but fear not.
Behind the horn?
Speaking of being behind the horn,
isn't
he's going to be with us next
telephone?
Week. This is a telephone.
No, this is not a telephone.
Well, this is a microphone.
A microphone?
Yes, this is the telephone.
Okay, that's a telephone. Now, you want them to get behind the what?
The horn.
The horn.
And give us a call. Yeah. Okay,
the second, you got my granddaughter laughing.
The second
to show
hour,
you.
Yeah, the
at
second
her age,
hour,
she'll laugh at anything. That's funny.
The second hour kind of grinds a little bit, guys. We're going to make it through. Let's go to Mary in Vermont here. Mary, welcome to your show.
Hello there.
Hey, Mary.
How's it going?
We're doing okay. Bob came back. He came back fighting.
I'm looking at, I wish I could see your grandchildren, Robert.
Oh, let me fix that for you. Hold on a second. Let me do a little pan and scan here. Here we go.
I've seen.
We got Conrad. Mike from Seattle.
Oh, I didn't even know that.
Did you show Mike?
Yeah, I sure did.
Right. Then Mike, did you wave or dance? Did you dance or anything, Mike?
Look at that shot.
And there's Conrad. Hi, Conrad.
We actually need another
and
camera.
And Alexi. Hi, yeah. Alexi.
Hello.
You guys are very photogenic. You definitely take
great
out your grandfather.
Great-looking kids.
Look at Alexi. Is she a hottie or what?
She is a hottie.
And my grandson's good-looking, but he's gay.
I don't believe
all
it.
The best ones are, Bob.
That's what you think.
I know.
Who would know better than you?
Oh, man. Well, that's nice. It's nice to have them there visiting.
Well, it's nice to have a balance.
Yeah, yeah. Well, listen, I got a question for you about one of your movies. It's kind of a silly question, I guess. But on Weekend of Terror, you have the scene where you're chasing the woman through the dark house, and she falls and hits her head and dies. And when you do that scene, when you discover that she's really dead, you just kind of freak. And I wanted to ask you a question about that.
Sure.
I hear the music.
Yeah, hang
go
in
ahead.
There, Mary.
What's the question?
Go ahead.
Okay. Well, it's hard to say it, but when you read the script for that, did you think then about what you were going to do or how you were going to play it, or did you wait till you were shooting the scene and then just roll with the emotion?
I waited till she died, but we'll talk to you when you come back out of commercial.
Okay.
But she lived in real life.
Oh, okay.
Guys, stick around. More great stuff coming up here. We'll be back right after this.
Get your Plenty card at X.
Exxon or Mobil and start earning points at lots of places.
So I get points for filling up at Exxon?
You sure do.
What about getting coffee at Mobil?
Points.
Streaming TV shows on Hulu?
Definitely.
Points on my AT&T wireless bill?
Yep.
Buying soap?
At Rite Aid.
Buying you a birthday present?
Points at Macy's.
Visiting your parents?
No. You get marriage points.
Oh.
Exxon and Mobil are the only fuel brands that are part of Plenty, the rewards program that lets you earn points at one place and use them at another. Join Plenty for free through a participating Exxon or Mobil station today. Terms and limitations apply. See Plenty.com/partners for details.
Step right up to the amazing taste of Coney Island Hard Root Beer. A delicious adult twist on an old favorite. The real root beer taste with a hint of vanilla will thrill your taste buds. Coney Island Hard Root Beer. Ask for it by name. Coney Island Brewing Company, Brooklyn, New York. Drink responsibly.
Staples has more for less on everything your business needs to make more happen every day. Plus free shipping and up to 5% back when you sign up for Staples Rewards. Staples, make more happen.
Got my fingers wrapped round a highball glass, and there's no way that I'm letting go till I'm high as I am low. I'll be here all night, so let the gin on ice go.
Welcome back, everybody, to the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad. We're just getting this train on the tracks. We got Mary on the line, and Mary brought up a question about Weekend of Terror, about the movie where Robert Conrad and Lee Majors play two kidnappers who kidnap three nuns, and they need a replacement for a dead hostage. Bob playing a bad guy, which, Bob, you didn't, I mean, you played bad guy a couple times.
Oh, I love to be a bad guy, because yeah. In real life, I am a bad guy.
You played a great bad guy.
Thanks, baby. I am a bad guy, aren't I, Sarah?
Yeah. You're not a bad guy.
Thank you, baby. What's
just
up?
Just ask Sarah. She'll tell you all about it. Go ahead, Bob. What's your question, Mary?
Okay, so, yeah, I wondered, you know, you said that you waited. I wondered, when you did that scene, I love that scene because you totally freak out when you find that she's dead. And I often wondered, when you read that script and said, okay, I'm going to have to, you know, find out that she's dead, did you plan, oh, I think I'll do this or do that, or did you just get so into the scene that that's what happened?
No, I killed someone first to see what it felt like.
Oh, you did? Oh, well, is that like, what is that? That's not method acting.
No, then after I found out how it acted, I reacted.
You reacted in the scene. Okay.
Yes.
Because you did a fabulous job.
Thank
with that.
You. So thank funny. You.
You're
thank
welcome.
You. That's great.
Okay. Well, I'll let you go. I'm glad you got your family there, and that's great. And I'll talk to you. Well, I'll talk to you next week.
Thanks, Quite Contrary.
Okay.
Okay,
I'm
baby.
Contrary.
Have
all
a good
right.
one. Mary, Mary,
you
Quite
too.
Contrary.
I love you.
How does your garden grow? With sugar nice and everything nice. That's how my garden grows.
I missed that.
Bye, baby.
Thank you.
Ciao.
Guys, let's head over now to Gabby in San Antonio. I think who Gabby is still compiling notes to write her own book on Mr. Robert Conrad.
Oh, Gabby, be careful.
Hi, Robert.
Hi, hi Gabby. How are you, Gabby? You little silly thing.
Well, you had mentioned earlier, and also on another week, you mentioned that you had been friends with Ronald Reagan.
Yeah, I would say so, kind of. I would hope so, yes. We were friends.
Did you become friends with him, you know, when he was still in acting? Or
yes,
was this like
when he was in acting.
Okay. So how did you come to meet him?
We bumped into each other on the studio, and we're chatting, and we said, hey, you want to have a cocktail? I said, yeah, I'll meet you at Chasen's. We met at Chasen's, and then every Friday after that, we would meet and have a couple cocktails and hang out and visit. And, you know, he ran for governor. I ran for king. I didn't win it as the king. He ran it as governor. And then I got a phone call at my lovely home up in Northern California, which is inundated now in heavy, heavy, heavy-duty snow. But anyway, I got the phone call, and the woman said, I'd like to speak with Mr. Conrad. The president is calling, and I was down in the gym, and my mother-in-law went, hi, the president's calling. She was from Alabama. The president's calling. The president of what? She said, the president of the United States. I said, yeah, right, okay, I'll be right up there. Climbing the stairs, I said, hello. She said, your Social Security number? I said, I gave it to her, and she said, the president would like to speak to you. So I said, hello. And he said, is this the king? And I said, yes, is this the president? He said, yeah. Hey, listen, how about having dinner? I said, well, that works for me, but how do we do that? He said, well, you pay your own airfare and I pay for dinner. I said, all right, we'll work it out. And we did it. We had dinner. It was fun. That's
did
all.
Did you visit him at the White House?
Yeah.
Were
yes.
there any other presidents that you visited at the White House?
No.
Just him?
Yep.
Okay. So I only had one other question for you. While you were, you know, in school, you know, playing sports, did you ever have any major injuries?
Major injuries playing sports? Let me think for a minute. No.
Okay. Well, thank you so much.
It's a pleasure, my darling. Thank you for your call. And if you have any more interesting questions, because I like that one, call me and I'll tell you. You know, if I knew anybody that I shouldn't have known, call me and I'll tell you.
Okay.
Au revoir, my darling.
All right. Well, I hope to talk to you all next week.
I hope so, too, baby, because it's whose show is it?
It's our show.
You got it. You figured it out. God bless you. Keep it on the air. You talk, we talk.
All righty. Love you.
Love you, baby.
There she goes. There goes Susie. I'm sorry. There goes Gabby. I don't. I'm looking at
Jose. Is Susie?
Jose's notes over there got me confused.
Got a little Susie going for
we got it? Susie over here online too.
Does the wife listen to the show?
Let's get to Susie in Boston.
You get home. She's going to say, "Who is Susie?"
She already did. She sent me a message on Facebook.
Good.
Hi.
Hey, Susie.
There?
How are you?
Hi. Hi, Eric, Sarah, Duke, Alexi, Conrad, and Mike.
Beautiful. You wrote them all down.
Yes, I did. I got all the artists. Now listen, you should have your family on more often. You look fantastic.
Thank you. They're cuties, aren't they?
Oh, listen, I'm a friend with Nancy on Facebook, and so she posts the pictures, and boy, apples don't fall far from the tree.
Thank you so much. That means me, because they're, the grandfather was not that good looking.
You're the great oak of the family here.
Yeah, I was the foundation of the family.
Conrad has your jaw and your dimples.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well,
and
good.
Alexi looks just like her mama.
All right. You got it now down.
They're analyzing us frame by frame, everybody. Yeah.
All right. Go ahead.
So, listen. I'm not sure if Eric or whoever does it or Courtney printed out from the Real Robert Conrad Facebook page. I printed out the information about the Judy Garland being on the Get TV. And the channels that it's on for Los Angeles, in case you get Time Warner Cable or Verizon or Charter. Okay, so maybe Sarah can print that out for you.
I have no idea what you're talking about, dear, but thank you for mentioning it.
Okay, Mel Torme, I told you last week, was going to be on a Judy Garland show.
Yeah, but they're all dead now.
Yeah, but I thought you wanted to listen to it. Okay, never mind, don't worry.
Okay, thank
don't
you, dear. All right.
No. I just want to know, how is your arm tonight?
Getting better. Eventually, I'm good. I think March 1st, the arm will be good. June 1st, I'll be good. And then I'm going to have a champagne party, and I'm going to invite some cable dancers there in bikinis.
All right. Pan gig, finally, Bob. Jeez,
well,
I
bring
money.
Them there. They put their little panties on and dance with the old man.
And yeah, Bob, no, you'll be feeling better on your birthday, March 1st.
That's right, sweetheart. Thank you. I'll be feeling even a lot better June 1st when they do the dancing.
Yes, you will. Listen, take care and God bless.
God bless you, sweetheart.
Bye-bye.
Guys, stick around. More great stuff coming up. We're taking a brief station break. When we come back, more of the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad.
And?
I'm Eric Hines, the consummate co-host.
I'm tired of telling you who you are.
You picked the one time I was actually going to say it, too.
Oh, you were going to say it.
Yeah, we'll be back.
Take that hat off. I'm going to take that hat off. You tell me one audience, tell me how much longer I have to put up with that goofy black hat.
This report is brought to you by Pfizer. If symptoms of a health issue slow you down, you're not alone. Your employer feels it too. According to a recent report by the Institute for Health and Productivity Management and Pfizer, Inc., a survey of 35 employers revealed that conditions like allergies, low back pain, and heartburn cost employers millions each year. One corporation reported $3.25 million lost annually in worker productivity because of these ailments. Other studies confirm that health issues result in significant costs to businesses, as impacted workers are often absent and less productive. However, help can come through access to over-the-counter medicine or OTCs. Studies estimate that every $1 spent on OTCs save the U.S. healthcare system $6 to $7 by reducing physician visits and medical expenses. Broad access to OTCs for the self-care of common ailments can help people find faster symptom relief, produce cost savings, and prevent lost productivity. Learn more about OTCs as a resource for self-care and wellness at ihpm.org.
When you're really looking forward to an outstanding holiday office party, you've got to contact Columbo's. Why? Well, if ever there were a time for good times, that time is now. 323-254-9138. 323-254-9138. Columbo's Italian Steakhouse and Jazz Club. Colorado Boulevard, Eagle Rock. Columbo's. Easy, delicious, affordable, great Italian specialties, mouth-watering steaks, the freshest fish, world-famous meatballs, and jazz every night. Big or not-so-big budget, it doesn't matter. Columbo's is L.A.'s number one people-pleasing destination. They do it right. It's friendly and festive, never fawning. Don't get left out. Call Columbo's now, 323-254-9138. Because when you're really looking forward to an outstanding holiday office party, you've got to contact Columbo's. Columbo's. Buon Natale. Mangia.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names.
Really? Yeah.
They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
If you're struggling to find reliable senior living information for your mom or dad, then call or go online to get the free help you need during this turbulent time. Call now, 800-471-5173, 800-471-5173.
I'm gonna love you like nobody's loved you, come rain or come shine. High as a mountain and deep as a river, come rain or come shine. I guess when you met me, it was just one of those things. But don't you ever bet me, 'cause I'm gonna be true if you let me.
Welcome back, everybody. It's the PM show with Mr. Robert Conrad. We're taking your calls. We're answering your emails.
Who else?
I'm Eric Hines, the consummate co-host.
Finally, I'm going to stop this. I'm going to pull this out and hit you in the head with it.
It wouldn't be the first time.
Thank you.
Let's go to, we already talked to Gabby, so I think Gabby's off the line.
Yeah, we'll Gabby's gone. She misses us. So.
Susie's gone. We got Gary Collins. Oh, you know who we have, Bob? We got Tommy from Chicago.
Let's do Gary first. You want to talk to Gary? Gary likes to call in and ask if I ever knew Tab Hunter.
And if you had lunch with Greta Garbo.
Right.
Let's find out. Hey,
okay.
Gary Collins, welcome.
Hey, Bob. How are you? Long time no talk.
How are you, my man?
I've been very busy, and I'm just doing fine. Thank you very much. Also, I just received word that Randy Mantooth is cancer-free. And I also asked your buddy Larry Panetti to call Randy and ask him to be a guest on his show where I can ask him a question.
All right. Works for me. Okay, what?
And speaking of questions, I have a question I wanted to ask you. Now, growing up, how old did you start singing?
I was singing professionally when I was 19. I sang in high school when I was 12.
Wow, that's nice. I have another question I wanted to ask of you.
Yes.
Were you friends with Ron Howard, the director?
Yeah, I knew Ronnie. Yeah, we weren't friends, but I know him, yeah, sure.
That's nice. Good. Thank you.
Okay, bro. All right. Nice talking to you.
There goes Gary.
Well, he's got that whole thing. He's got it all written down, who knew who, when, and so on and so forth.
He's a TV expert.
I think Gary is, yes, yeah. Definitely.
Okay, let's get over to Indianapolis. Oh, let's go to Tommy. You got it, Jose. Thanks, buddy.
Go to who?
Let's go to Tommy. I keep getting cued by Sarah to hit those emails. Don't worry, guys. We definitely.
Are we going to do any emails?
We're going to do some emails.
But let's finish with the phoners.
Yeah, let's get the board.
Okay, let's close the board. Let's do the emails. We got to do it, man.
Let's do it.
You just don't want to do emails.
I'll do whatever you want.
You know what they want. It's our audience.
I was going to do that table dance thing you're talking about.
No, you're not going to do it.
Paying cash?
You got a little Lulu. I saw that.
Yeah. That's good. Tommy Wilson, all the way from Chicago, your hometown. Tommy, welcome to the show, buddy.
Hey, I'd like to order one order of linguine with white clam sauce and a beef sandwich with some jardiniere peppers.
Oh,
perfect.
There you go.
I love it. There you
Made
go.
Man. Yep.
Okay. I found you guys through my girlfriend, Janet. Now, I'm from Chicago. I'm from the South Side. Many years ago, somebody told me that you were a milkman, which I was a milkman. But I did listen to one of your shows, and you mentioned that you were with Consolidated Freightways. I don't know if that's the one that was on Cicero Avenue. Is that where you worked?
2000 West 32nd Street.
Okay, you're still on the South Side.
That's right, very south.
But anyway, I've listened to the show. It was nice to hear from you.
Thanks.
Anybody from that time period, I'm from the same time period you came from, and we had such a beautiful, wonderful life and a great city. And you mentioned the other day, I think you said you lived around 50th and Greenwood, and you went back home.
Yeah, 5026 South Greenwood.
Yeah, I went back home about 12 years ago, and it's you cry. That's what you do.
Well, I couldn't get in there. They had the gate blocked because the president had the house right next to the school that I went to. So they wouldn't let us in, which is very disappointing because I wanted to show it to my love interest. Grandma and I were going to go look at it, but they wouldn't let us in, would they, Grandma? Anyway, yeah. Go ahead.
That's a shame. And I went back, it was gone. You know, my house, I thought I lived in a beautiful two-flat on 69th and Polina. And as I look at the pictures on the computer, you know, you can go with the gizmo, with the maps or Google.
Sure.
And it looked like my building was about 15 feet wide.
Wow. How about that?
So it was a great place. I live between the Undertaker and the milk dairy over there.
Well, good. Hey, thanks for your call, brother. We got to move on.
Okay.
Thanks,
nice
Tommy.
Nice talking to you.
Yeah. Call next week. We'll talk more.
Experience a luxury boutique hotel escape in the heart of Laguna Beach, California, with the finest art gallery, shopping, dining, and nightlife just steps from your door. The heart of Laguna Beach, the edge of the sea. It's the Inn at Laguna Beach. Enjoy our comfortable rooms, blending the style of a timeless beach bungalow with the modern comforts of today. 70 newly appointed guest rooms and suites await you at the Inn at Laguna Beach. Then, relax at the rooftop bar, where you'll indulge in breathtaking views of the ocean. For dining, you'll find libations and local cuisine on the California coastline, including dining at the legendary Las Brisas, a Southern California landmark. The Inn at Laguna Beach. Footsteps from room to village to sea, located in the heart of Laguna Beach. The Inn is within walking distance of all that Laguna Beach has to offer. No car required. The Inn at Laguna Beach. 211 North Coast Highway in Laguna Beach, California. Call 800-544-4479 or visit innatlagunabeach.com.
I am a non-attorney spokesperson. Attention men who've taken Androgel or any other testosterone therapy products. Androgel or other low-T products have been linked to heart attack, stroke, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, even death. Scientific studies indicate that the use of testosterone therapy products may double a man's risk of heart attack. If you or a loved one took Androgel or a testosterone therapy product and suffered from a heart attack, stroke, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, or any other cardiac event, you might be entitled to financial compensation. You have rights, and you need to let us fight for your rights. And you pay no fees unless we win. So call the tort attorneys right now. 800-557-7921. 800-557-7921. That's 800-557-7921. Cases may be referred to participating law firms in your jurisdiction.
You order a glass of your favorite Cabernet, fresh asparagus, hollandaise on the side, a filet, medium rare. You unfurl your napkin with a flare, close your eyes, and prepare to listen. Ah, there it is. The sweet music you long to hear. The sizzle. The sizzle of a Ruth's Chris steak.
The most magnificent corn-fed prime beef. Broiled to perfection at 1,800 degrees. Some call it a sizzle. We call it an anthem.
As the waiter approaches, you think, is this one mine or that one?
Ruth's Chris Steakhouse. Like Ruth always said, life's too short to eat anywhere else.
Make a reservation online at rootschris.com or by calling 800-544-0808.
You hear that, kid? That's the hum of a well-run facility. You know what I hate hearing? Silence. Silence on a production line means downtime. Downtime means wasted time. Wasted time means wasted money. Silence isn't golden, kid. It's deadly. That's why I love Grainger. With a wide variety of the latest products, Grainger gets us what we need when we need it to help keep this place up and running and humming away. Get it? Got it? Good. Call, click Grainger.com, or stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
The Doug Steffen Good Day Program, early morning radio, and I guess it is radio, although it's radio on TV because this is CRN Digital Talk. You can find out what's going on in the world. We talk about the issues of the day, the events of the day, the people that people are talking about. We have an interesting way of looking at the news and having a little fun with the issues. So if you want to have some fun, learn a few things, and get up on the right side of the world, Doug Steffen's Good Day Program, weekday mornings, 2 to 7 a.m. on CRN Digital Talk.
Such a bad thing to run away from my mother, right into the arms of a lover. I should walk away from you in my brand new shoes, because I'm just too young for the blues.
Welcome back, everybody. It is the PM show with Mr. Robert Conrad. We are taking your calls, 818-353-1276, 818-353-1276. I'm Eric Hines, the consummate co-host on this wild, wild ride. And where we last left off...
Are you actually talking while my daughter's singing?
Someday when I know the rules, because I'm just too young for the blues.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Let's get to Patrina in Indianapolis. Patrina, welcome to your show, sweetie.
What's up, Patrina girl?
Hey, I hope you can hear me okay. I've got a little touch of bronchitis.
A little
we can hear you, baby. Speak up. And what's on your mind?
Well, I was wondering, what is the most number of takes that you've had to do when you've done a love scene or kissing scene?
On a kissing scene, usually one take, because I never quit.
Okay.
There was a lot of tongue exercises there.
So nobody made any mistakes or anything?
No, we just hung in there and going, yeah, baby, more, more, more.
Ooh. Yeah. Okay. Well, that was all that I wanted to know.
Well, that's all it was. I enjoyed and I embraced, and I never met a woman I didn't like. You've heard that before.
Yes, I sure have, and we sure enjoy watching you do that, too.
Well, thanks, baby. I enjoy doing it. Yeah.
Okay, well, you guys have a good week, and I'll talk to you next week.
Well, thank you, dear. Thanks for your call, okay? Call
okay.
Next. I have more questions for you. If you want to know what girl I had the most sex with, I'll tell you.
Oh, boy.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Your favorite one, huh?
Bye-bye.
Okay, there we go. Where did this go? I don't know where this just went.
I don't know. It was a tease. I would never say that. Are you kidding me?
What's up, blushing?
Would okay. I ever say that?
I don't think so.
No.
Not in the time.
I don't want your girlfriend to hear it.
Thank you very much. Let's get to Wendy in Vermont. Vermont's in the house today. Let's get to Wendy over here. Wendy, welcome to your show.
Hello?
Hi, Wendy.
Hi.
Hey.
Hey, I don't know if I can talk after that last question.
I know, right?
Catch
off guard. Yeah, no kidding.
Wendy, we were teasing. It's all fun. Come on.
All right. Well, I've got a teasy for you then. A couple weeks ago, you asked for people to send you photos in their bathing suit.
Yes.
So I sent you an email, and I hope you think it's funny because it was sent in jest.
Well, Guess what? I haven't opened the email because I've been in and out of town, but I'm going next week to go through those, and when I see it, I will show it.
All right. Well, there's also a nice photo of you and Ross Martin. It's very artistic.
I don't care about that. I care about you, baby.
You look much better than I do.
Well, we'll see. You're the one. You're the one. You're the seventh son.
Hey, I had a quick question for you.
Sure. I got an old question for you.
Do you eat maple syrup?
Yeah.
I'm over here in Vermont, and I usually mail out maple syrup to people at Christmas.
I love maple syrup.
Oh. Well, great. We're famous for that over here in Vermont. That and, you know, granite, but I don't want to send you a tombstone and make you nervous.
No, I don't want that, baby. Thank you. Not yet.
Don't need that.
Not yet.
All right. So I see you had your grandkids on tonight.
They're right in front of me. Can you see them?
You know what? I can't. I'm up in the room without a computer, but I'll watch
but
it.
They're really nice looking. One of them looks like me. The guy looks like Dracula, but the girl looks like me.
I saw a picture of them earlier.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
So do they eat maple syrup? I can send some.
Do you eat maple syrup? Yeah, she loves it.
Do you like maple syrup?
He likes it. And do you like maple syrup? On his pancakes.
On his pancakes.
We had to wake him up for that one. He looked at me like,
not paying attention.
No.
Yeah. Yeah, we get all kinds of that stuff.
Good girl.
All right, well, I'll let you go because you probably get a lot of people to talk to before the end of the show. But
well, no, we're going to get off the phone because we've been on it all afternoon. And we're going to get into some of these emails, I hope.
All right, well, if you find my email, it's pretty funny. I'm pretty pale.
Well, no sun in Vermont.
Well,
we'll work it out. We'll see what about that. You know what I'm saying?
The picture of me down in Florida. So.
Well, good. We'll see it. We'll check it out. I'll let you know next week. Come on, baby.
All right. I'll call you next week.
I hope so.
All right. Thanks. Good night.
Good night, baby.
There she goes.
Bye-bye.
Thanks, Wendy. All right, that's it for our final caller. We still have some lines open, though. Guys, give us a call.
No, wait a minute. Well, I thought we were going to do these emails,
no, we're doing some emails. Yeah, I'm just giving
them. Why do you keep doing this? You keep loading up that, and we'll never get to these emails.
Oh, no,
beautiful,
no,
baby.
We got plenty of time.
Where did you get that?
Oh, we got a glass of Chardonnay. Nice. Yeah. Very nice. All right.
A glass of Chardonnay to you, my friends, Romans countrymen. Lend my ears. I come to bury Caesar, not to praise him. The noble Brutus, it says, he was ambitious. If this were so, it was a grievous fault, and grievously, as he answered it.
Huh? Very good, sir.
You didn't know that your guy from the neighborhood could do a little Shakespeare, real.
All right, guys, let's get to some emails. Bob, do you want me to start this off? David Barissa.
No,
David,
I don't want you to start it off. Go on, will you?
David Barissa, will you be attending the Mid-Atlantic Nostalgia Convention this year? The answer to that, David, is no. Keith Schumacher, Mr. Conrad, I loved Wild Wild West.
What is that convention that she's talking about?
Mid-Atlantic Nostalgia Convention, and I'm guessing you probably haven't heard of it yet, but I'll try to pull up details on it. But I'm guessing that because of your busy holiday schedule, you probably won't be able to attend.
Okay, good.
Then, of course, Keith Schumacher saying he loved the Wild Wild West and Baba Black Sheep. And, of course, our good buddy Jess DC, also my friend on Facebook here, with his unimitable style. sitting there with his glass of red wine, a cigar, and a Bob Conrad on the computer screen as he's watching the show live. Jess, thank you so much for participating in the show. We love you, buddy.
Thank you, bro, for that.
Also, from Matt Klossert, Matt says, when is Black Sheep Squadron going to be televised again on MeTV? You know what, Matt? We don't know, but I'd say get a petition together and send it over to MeTV, and we will definitely sign it.
Get Wild West. I want to see Wild West again.
Cool. I want to see that as well. I'd love to
see
that.
You know, it's down in my living room, but you know how often I watch it?
How often?
I haven't watched it since it arrived.
Oh, boy.
Oh, well. There's no vanity there.
Well, you know, if it's on TV, I'm sure you'll just tune it in. And just
Do you think so?
Yeah, well, I don't know.
Well, if it's on TV, I might. I'm not vain about that
stuff. How about Alexi Douches? Yeah.
Yeah.
I like that.
Turn all the TVs on, have Black Sheep in one room.
Yeah, exactly. Wild Wild West, yeah.
Yeah, and Centennial. That's the one we all want to watch. Watch Centennial, people. It's the best work Conrad's ever done.
There we go. Guys, stick around. More great stuff coming up. We are still taking calls, so fear
not. Hi, Robert and Eric. I have a poll idea that may be fun to do on the show. Should Eric cut off his ponytail? Yes, because Uncle Bob knows what he's talking about. No, he should continue to grow it longer. Yes, but only after growing a few locks of love. Many blessings to you both, Lauren.
Go. That's not a bad idea, Lauren. I might donate to Locks of Love this year. We'll see.
I think, Lauren, you are absolutely on top of your game. Thank you for that.
We'll be back.
Get rid of that hair, you freak.
Got a lot on your to-do list? Now, during Kubota's Power to Do Great Things sales event, get a great deal on an L3301 or 3901 tractor with a live continuous running rear PTO. Now get financing as low as 0% APR for up to 5 years and great customer instant rebates when you buy a new L3301 or 3901 and two implements. Now through December 31st, 2015. Call toll-free 1-888-465-8268 for details about cost and terms. For more information or to find a participating dealer, visit Kubota.com.
For over 75 years, GEICO's kept an eye on the future, keeping customers happy with things like 24/7 customer support and emergency roadside service. And to prove it, here's one of our commercials from over 75 years ago.
At GEICO, we promise to always find innovative new ways to serve you. In fact, we're so innovative, in 75 years, they'll listen to this old radio commercial and think, wow, they were innovative.
Wow, we are innovative.
GEICO, saving people money for over 75 years.
What are you going to do with your old car? You can try selling it, you could junk it, or you could donate it to Heritage for the Blind. Your car will be towed away for free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats. It doesn't matter if your vehicle runs or not. It will be towed away for free, and you'll be supporting those that need help. Heritage for the Blind is a nonprofit organization that helps the visually impaired live fuller lives. Call right now to donate your car, and as a special thank you for calling, you'll receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to many exciting locations. Call Heritage for the Blind right now, 1-800-785-9618. Donating is easy, and your vehicle is towed away for free. Plus, you'll get a free vacation voucher. Call now, 1-800-785-9618. That's 1-800-785-9618.
Someday, when I'm awfully low, when the world is cold, I will feel the glow just thinking of you and the way you look tonight. Yes, you're lovely.
Welcome back, everybody. This is the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad. And I swear I just went through puberty right there. Welcome back, everybody. We are still taking phone calls. This is the last segment for phone calls. So if you've been chomping at the bit trying to get through and the phones have been busy, now's your chance. We have four lines open, but this is the last chance to call in. So be sure to jump on it now. Bob, I did want to read you a couple more, and I know you had some over there. This one is from Al Menendez Michelina, and this one's kind of presumptuous here, Bob. I'm going to read this to you. Well, he says here, if indeed this is the real Robert Conrad, Oh, happy really? To see you here, sir. Yeah, so,
I am the real Conrad. I don't care what you think.
Yeah, so there you go.
How is that? Was too gay or no?
It's right in the pocket. There you go.
It was, yes, it was. Listen, listen, the cats. Where? Under the chair. Run, run, get the, gun. Oh, shucks, it's all done.
So, Al, there you go. You did, in fact, touch base with the real Mr. Robert Conrad. He is here in studio, and we just read your email. Also, one here from Susie Yount. Susie Yount says, got my daughter some...
Wait a minute. What was the question? Did he say anything?
No, just says, I hope you're doing well. Happy to see
was
you
that
here.
It? Hey, man, thanks for taking the time to send that, and I hope you didn't mind me kidding you about being, you know... Lighten my loafers.
We're a bunch of kidders over here.
All right, good. Thanks.
And so from Susie Yount. Susie Yount says, I got my daughter some of the DVDs of Battle of the Network Stars. Oh, boy. And we have enjoyed seeing you sparring with Telly and Howard and all the rest. Lots of fun to see you again. Telly Savalas, of course, referring to Telly Savalas.
Yeah. Yeah, it was fun to do. It was really fun.
You were quite the competitor, too, sir. I think you actually...
I like to win. You know, it was my whole life. I always like to compete.
I think you actually cussed in German a few times in the show. I seem to remember you saying...
Was ist das?
Was ist das Scheiße? I think I remember hearing all this. I think I heard this stuff.
Well, I think you're imagining it. You know.
It's all over YouTube.
I'll tell you what's going to
so
happen. We'll get through this probably till Christmas. But in the new year, I'm going to bring a couple of my friends from the neighborhood... It would have cut that hair off.
Oh, man.
Whether he likes it or not.
Oh, man. Is this like a scene from Goodfellas?
That's going to be.
Is this what's going to happen?
It's going to happen, pal. It's not a threat. It's a guarantee.
Yeah. Go home and get your shine box.
That's right.
All right. Okay. So are we doing emails? I got a couple more for you, sir, while you're enjoying that great glass of Chardonnay. Lauren.
That's not Chardonnay.
A Gewürztraminer, then.
It is, you can't drink iced tea without it being called Chardonnay.
That's right, absolutely.
All right, go ahead.
A light Chardonnay. Lauren Morgan Richards. Let's see a new Wild Wild West series with Jim West performed by Shane Conrad and President Grant performed by Robert Conrad.
All
that's
you
actually
have
a
to
legit
do
idea.
Is send that to CBS, to the presidency, and say you would like to see the show back on the air and have Robert Conrad portrayed by his lookalike, Shane Conrad, who is a wonderful actor, And then, you know, I'd direct a few episodes and we'll get it back on the air, and it would be a hit.
Oh,
in today's community, please, it'll be a hit.
Even more important, though, Bob, you got to look at
Conrad,
this.
What do you think?
I'd watch it.
I'd watch it, too.
I'd watch it. Now, wait a minute. Alexi,
Lauren actually, okay,
would you
Alexi,
watch
please,
it?
Yeah.
No,
you wouldn't watch it.
No.
Did she say, "Oh no"? I'm gonna pour this Chardonnay
minute,
on her head.
You slip here. Wait a minute.
I thought I heard something else. That you
forget said. About it. Can you take her home with you tonight?
Oh no.
You had one job, Alexi.
Lauren did take it one step extra, though, Bob. What she did is she actually looks like she did some kind of photoshopping here. And you might not be able to pick it up on camera because it's very subtle, but she actually put Shane's face over yours, and she put your face over President Grant. And I'm going to show the viewers online first, and then I'll pass it around the room. But this is hilarious. If you notice, that is Shane Conrad's face superimposed over Bob's body. And then if you look up there at Grant, she did quite a good job with the putting the beard on there. That is actually Mr. Robert Conrad's face with a beard covering it. That's great stuff.
Let me
stuff.
See this, man.
Lauren, thank you. That got me laughing over here. That's
let me see
good
this.
Stuff.
Damn. That's
funny.
No, it's frightening.
Yeah, absolutely.
Hey,
yeah,
Lauren, I'm going to hang on to this, but I want you to take this and I want you to send this to the president of CBS because this thing ought to get made again and this is the guy who ought to play me. God, he looks so much like the Wild West character. But I worry about it sometimes when I think about it, if it becomes a reality. Because, you know, I almost died on the show. And when it was canceled, I've told this story before, but it's worth repeating. The president of the network called me, and I was in a dressing room for a charity I'd done up in Rochester, New York, a fundraiser for some kids. And a phone rings, and he said, Bob, we're canceling the show. And I said, really? It's got the ratings. He said, no, it's got the heat from the Women Against Violence on television. Mm-hmm. We can't deal with that. We don't need to deal with it. And I said, you know, I'm not disappointed because I knew one of us, if we continued, was going to die. And I meant that. And I meant it then, and I mean it now. It was a very, very, very difficult show to do. And we kept accelerating our stunts, making them more challenging and more butch and more strength and more hoorays. And that was partially my fault. And then when it got canceled, I was happy.
There you go.
There you go.
That's it.
C'est la vie.
There's the truth. Guys, stick around. More great stuff coming up. The final segment here on the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad. The holiday season is
behind us. How many minutes is the final show?
4 minutes, the final segment.
There's 4 more minutes left?
4 more minutes, yeah.
So can I dance?
Go for it. Absolutely, yeah.
We got to take these back because we never got to them, and this is depressing. And this is your fault.
I don't mind being the scapegoat, sir. Guys, stick around. More great stuff coming up. The final segment here on the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad. I'm Eric Hines. We'll be back right after this on CRN Digital.
We got to keep this. I want this on the top of the list. Can you help me with this?
Yeah.
Because Marlita wants to know if I ever had a Christmas song.
Experience the romantic getaway you deserve at Maui's premier bed and breakfast, the Plantation Inn. With plantation-style architecture and decor combined with modern amenities such as dual rain showers and whirlpool hot tubs, guests relax in a tranquil oasis in the heart of Maui's historic Lahaina town. The inn is situated conveniently less than 2 blocks from Lahaina Harbor, as well as the famous French Street, known for its range of shops, restaurants, gallery walks, and museums. The Plantation Inn is home to Gerard's Restaurant, voted Open Table's top most romantic restaurants in North America. Chef Gerard's contemporary island French cuisine consistently earns some of the highest ratings in Hawaii. Come discover why Hawaii Magazine readers named the Plantation Inn #1 best bed and breakfast in Hawaii. Visit theplantationinn.com or call us at 667-9225.
Are you worried about losing your home to foreclosure? If you've been threatened with foreclosure or receive legal papers from your bank, you have approximately 30 days to respond. If you do not respond, you could lose your home. You have rights. Act now to protect your rights. You can stay in your home. Many times you can even modify your loan. The bottom line is you can get past this, but you must act right now. If you've been served by your bank and you're worried about losing your home to foreclosure, now is the time to fight back and save your home. Time is limited, so call the professionals at National Foreclosure Defense right now.
800-515-6309. 800-515-6309. 800-515-6309. 800-515-6309. That number again is 800-515-6309.
You order a glass of your favorite Cabernet, fresh asparagus, hollandaise on the side, a filet, medium rare. You unfurl your napkin with a flair, close your eyes, and prepare to listen. Ah, there it is. The sweet music you long to hear. The sizzle. The sizzle of a Ruth's Chris steak.
The most magnificent corn-fed prime beef, broiled to perfection at 1,800 degrees. Some call it a sizzle. We call it an anthem.
As the waiter approaches, you think, is this one mine or that one?
Ruth's Chris Steakhouse. Like Ruth always said, life's too short to eat anywhere else.
Make a reservation online at rootschris.com or by calling 800-544-0808.
This couldn't happen again. This is that once in a lifetime. This is a thrill divine. What's more, this never happened before. Though I have prayed for a lifetime that such as you would suddenly be mine. Mine to hold as I'm holding you now, and yet never so near.
Oh, I love this song.
Mine to
welcome back,
everybody.
Here's the final segment of the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad. We're so glad you could join
and
us.
And our engineer.
Of course, Engineer Jose holding
hey,
it down.
Hey, Jose, thanks for playing that song on the way out. It's my favorite song. And there was another person, very famous, that sang it. And I had the tape, and I turned it off. again. Thanks, man. You're the best, Jose. You're my favorite. You know that.
I want to remind our listeners out there to be sure to give us a call each week. 818-353-1276 is
858.
The call line. 818.
818.
Yeah, the Valley, San Fernando Valley.
Oh, so
yeah.
Can I hear that again?
818.
818.
353-1276.
1276.
That's it. That's absolutely it, brother. And I want to give a big shout out to Mike for coming all the way down from Seattle to join
Let's
us today.
Let's hear from Mike. Yeah. Hey, Mike. Oh, yeah, yeah, Mike. Okay.
There we go.
I'd like to say thank you on behalf of myself and all of your fans out there for you doing this show to give back. And after 50 years of watching you on television, this is a real thrill for me, and I really appreciate it.
Well, I appreciate that. Awesome. And that couldn't have been 50 years because I'm only 47.
Of course, Alexi and Conrad joining us in studio today
as
well.
Oh, my grandchildren.
Thank you so much, guys.
Look at my grandchildren.
Absolutely.
Aren't they cute?
Yes. Bob, you did a great job.
I love you. God bless Absolutely. You. God bless you. God bless
Absolutely.
You.
I know we still got a couple minutes. We're good.
Well, I want to say God bless to my audience.
Oh, yeah.
You and I do that every time I'm on the air, right?
Yeah, you sure do.
Because I'm a good Christian.
Sir, yes, sir. And That's speaking right. of Christian, Christmas coming up, of course, so just a couple weeks. Everyone's doing their Christmas shopping.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you know what I celebrated Christmas?
What do you do?
Same thing Mom and I always celebrated.
What's that?
Nothing.
Oh, really? So you're still doing that, huh? You're keeping the festivities light.
Mother
this year.
And I never, ever, ever celebrated Christmas.
Wow.
Wow.
Are you kind of bah humbug then around this time of year?
No, I'm not. I love Christmas and people who celebrate it. No, I love it. And Easter Sunday. No, I'm very supportive of Christianity, but it's a celebration about the birth of Christ, not about presents.
Oh, there you go.
And that's okay. What offends me. Go out and buy a ton of presents. What does that have to do with Christ? What does that have to do with religion? Nothing.
Oh, okay, all right. Well, I'm sure there's a lot of people that agree with
and
you.
Mom
there.
Used to yeah. jump up and down and say, "You don't do it." And I used to say, "Ma, I'll do whatever you say." She said, "Just we'll go to church." And I went to church with her, and that's how we celebrated it.
So she wasn't too big on the whole consumer Christmas. She wanted family
never
time.
Never bought and me a Christmas present as long as I lived.
Well, I'll buy you a Christmas present.
I don't want one. I've got a Christmas present. Her name's Ellie.
Oh, there we go. That's really sweet of you, Bob.
That's right.
Oh, that's really nice.
Oh, is she on the air now?
Makes me feel gushy.
I want to say that to her.
She's hearing you now.
Can you hear me, baby? You know what you are? You are my Christmas present. I love you with all my heart. I love you. I love you. I love you. You're my girl.
That's it. All right, guys. Remember, next week coming up, Mr. Michael Horn is going to be joining us on the show. And then we're going to have 2 weeks of great holiday best of shows, the Christmas best of.
What?
And of course,
we're not going to be on the air?
No, of course. Christmas Eve and New Year's Eve, of course.
Well, God bless you and God bless you. And we'll figure out that. I just heard this for the first time. Yeah. So, hey, you guys.
Oh, we got one more week, though. So
one more week. We're off the
then
air
we're
for how long?
For 2 weeks.
Oh,
Christmas
wow.
Eve and New Year's Eve.
I may have to leave town then.
Take me with you. I'll
Why?
Join. Yeah, we'll
I
do a remote
take
show.
That here. That think we were, you know, soft and light in our loafers.
Hey, we'll go buy some new loafers.
Maybe.
Guys, remember the website, crntalk.com, is a place to be for all things Mr. Robert Conrad. Check out the blog site. Of course, send us emails at robertconrad@crntalk.com. Mr. Conrad, parting words?
Yes, God is great, and God is good, and God thanks you, and God and I thank you.
Enjoying all your favorite CRN programming is easier than ever. It's right on your TV, through your local cable provider, and on the web at crntalk.com. But when you're on the move, stuck in a plane, train, or in your car, catch up on all the shows you missed, or listen live to your favorites. Download our CRN app from your iPhone, iPad, Android, or BlackBerry. Just search for CRN Digital Talk Radio. Or search for your favorite CRN shows on apps like iTunes, iHeartRadio, Stitcher, TuneIn Radio, AHA Radio, Ootunes, and Nobex. Now you have access to all of our great shows anywhere in the world and the ability to be part of them by calling our toll-free studio line at 800-336-2225. For more information on where and how to listen, log on to crntalk.com and create your own listening experience today.
The Radio Channel.
From townhall.com, I'm Keith Peters. The FBI has divers combing through a lake in a San Bernardino park looking for evidence surrounding the murders.